Okay, so I was checking out Itch for some other weird, cheap or free games. And I remember hearing about this, the Haunted PS1 Demo Disc 2020. If you had an original PlayStation, you probably remember it's kind of a new thing. They would have demo discs, like Square had a demo disc for their games, or the PlayStation came with like a tech demo disc, the thing with the little Tyrannosaurus you could control. So it's kind of a new thing for consoles, I think. I believe this was the first real demos. So this is a collection of little, I don't know, like little demos, mini games with like a horror theme and with sort of like a general PS1 aesthetic. They kind of vary a lot. I've kind of poked around a few of them. But yeah, overall, it's kind of cool. And like I say, it's free to try. I don't download it on Itch. There may be other options. I don't know. And it does, I believe it is Windows only. So we will get going. So yeah, it's kind of the PS themed intro. So yeah, they're definitely trying to go for that approach. Let's see. So I believe there are a ton of demos. I've tried a few of them. A few of them I've just checked out. Effigy is kind of like a first-person shooter. It's a little. Mean, if you like first-person shooters, you'll like it. It's not my first choice. Let's see. What will we try? Lots to choose from. Let's try Sauna 2000. So let's see. Credits created by Moya Horror, Amos Sori, bunch of other people. Description: Sauna warming simulator. Feel Finland. Finland feels you. All right. Here we go. Play. Sauna 2000, made in Unity. Okay, sounds scary, doesn't it? All right, here we go. Chop wood, carry water from Lake Bisana, warm the sauna, heat the bathing water, enjoy. Drink beer responsibly.
Heti saunan lämmityksen ennen kuin aurinko laskee.
Have to warm the sauna before sunset. Let's move my keyboard around here.
Mihinköhän sen kirveen tuuppasin?
Find axe. Where is the axe? I'm sure this is just what Finland looks like. Oh, that's kind of pretty. Yeah, I dig this sort of aesthetic, you know, like the bands of colors. They only have so many, so much quality to work with. So we are looking for an axe. There's the sun. There's water over there. No idea what this guy's saying.
Kirves.
Axe. If you're from Finland, maybe you know what they're talking about. Aha! Got to chop a couple of logs for firewood.
Liian kiireellä.
Not so fast.
Parempi
Better take aim
käydä
for a
hetkiä
bit.
kerralla, perkele.
God damn it. Nice. With one hit.
Kerralla
Great.
Liian
Damn it.
kiireellä.
Not
Parempi
so
käydä
fast.
hetkiä kerralla, perkele.
Damn it. Alright, got our wood.
Sitten
Now to the
saunalle.
sauna. Yes, sir, very pretty. That sounded creepy. I'm sure there's nothing wrong. Carry water. From pier to sauna. Now water from the end of the pier. There's a boat. We should just get in the boat and get the hell out of here, because we know nothing good is gonna come of this. Even if it's just named Sauna 2000. Let's go dip the bucket at the pier. Yes. Do. This would be very creepy in VR. I have not I do not have any of those headsets yet. That would be cool.
Tästä tulee ihan tarpeeksi kuumaa kylpyvettä.
It's getting... sun's going down.
Kyllä toinen ämpärillinen tuonne
varmaan mahtuu. I think it can still fit another bucket full. Sun's going down. Do. Oh boy. I think we saw something out there.
No me. No way.
Add wood to the furnace.
Mitähän näki? Hyvää kun tsekkasin, pitääpä tyhjätä. Missä se tuhka ämpäri tää tyhjätä?
Have to empty the ash and find matches.
Pihallapa pihalla.
I have not seen any matches. Sun's going down. They said we have to do it by sundown. Matches. Fuck. I don't see matches. Matches. Fuck. In the car? Car has matches? Trunk? Fuck. Matches. Sun's going down. Matches. Did I miss them somewhere? Oh, is there a... Can I... Oh, shit. There we go. Alright. Now what? Warm the sauna. Forgot to open the top hatch. Is that what this is for? Forgot to open the top hatch. I don't see a hatch. Oh, it probably means this. Yeah? No? Top hatch.
Pelti auki.
Hatch open. Right. Now what?
Pelti auki.
Hatch open. Now what?
Pimiähän tuo tulleempi.
It's getting dark. That doesn't sound good. Warm sauna. Let's shut the door. There we go. Warm the sauna. Oh boy. That doesn't sound good. Doesn't sound good. Warming. Go away. The sauna is occupied. Oh fuck, is this? What the shit? Got to go. Alright, we'll go. Oh boy. Oh shit. Oh boy. Fuck. Oh boy. I just wanna... Okay. We are no longer in the sauna, clearly. I wonder what happens if you actually get all the steps done. Dead, loud dead bodies. Dead people. Loud people. Okay, we're going to a house. There's a freaky lady in the tub, it looks like. There's a dude playing a game that's us playing, looking at him playing what we're... I don't know. Is there any food? Can't go back that way. Hey kid, ugh. Oh shoot, I think we're controlling him now. Interesting. Ah, run! Run! Run away! Oh Jesus, I can't even see. Run away! Run! Run faster! Run faster! Run! 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 Oh shit! Another sauna? Okay, this is weird. This is like a... Weird. Sounds like we got flip-flops on or something. There's us. So are we still us or are we the kid now? Oh boy. I don't like this. Huh. I'm not sure. Where's the kid? Hello, baby. Oh! No, that's nothing. Oh, what the... Are we in Japan now? Huh. We were in Finland, now we're in Japan apparently. Weird. Oh, now this now. Please insert Pray Salvation CD-ROM. Moya Horror 2020. Well, I like the graphics. It's a little... I don't know. It's interesting. I feel like it would probably make more sense if you did certain things in the right order. Demo over? Question mark? Just like the Blob movie. Okay, that's good. Good. Okay. That was interesting. I like the aesthetic for sure, the graphics. Let's see. What now? Tasty ramen. A colorful horror game about a haunted ramen mascot. Well, sure. We'll look at the credits after we're done. Made with Unity. Tasty ramen, hot horror flavor. Press E to start. Oh, hey. Welcome to the special gameplay demo version of Tasty Ramen. Just a quick explanation before we can start. You can run while holding the shift key. You can grab items by pressing E. You can place them by pressing E again. Pressing the left mouse button makes you throw them. Remember, items hit the ground can make attracting noises. One last thing. If you get tired of the game, escape lets you leave right away. That's it. Let's go. Ha! It's a key. Do we have to... What was throw? I forgot already. Alright. Ramen? Do we put it in? Hello? Oh. Oh boy. That's no good. Aha! We have to get these keys. Oh shit. Oh fuck! Try again. Press R to restart. Okay, we'll try again. I don't know. So you gotta figure out which keyhole. Oh fuck, where'd it go? Oh, I guess you just throw it at it. No. Okay, we'll give this one more try. I don't think I'm getting it. So if we just pick it up and throw. Yes. So how does... Oh shit. Here, have some ramen. Okay, we'll give it one more try. I'm clearly not getting this. Throw you. Maybe we'll throw the microwave at him. Come here, asshole. Oh, we just gotta... This is kind of like a stealth game, I see. Okay. We can do this, we can do this. He's over there. Where is he? I hear him. Alright, we're halfway there. I'm gonna... Fuck. Oh boy. Shit. Get it? No. All right. Well, that's interesting. I think we're good. It'd be interesting to see what the full game is like. Let's see. What will we try next? Narrative adventure about mice. Maybe next time if we do multiples. Heartworm. Sam receives a strange tape in the mail. Much of it brings her to a deeply unsettling place that feels strangely familiar. This looks kind of Silent Hill-ish. We'll give this a try. A game by Vincent Andinolfi? Andinolfi? Oh yeah, this is like Resident Evil style for sure. Move forward, move backwards, turn left, turn right, L to interact, shift to run, and tab for inventory. L to interact, that's interesting. My TV and VCR. I don't really feel like watching anything right now. Okay. Clinician's evaluation. Oh, this feels definitely Resident Evil-ish. Subjective. Maybe they mean subject? I don't know. Sam, redacted, 23-year-old female, average height, weight, no relevant medical history. Patient reported insomnia, recurring intrusive thoughts related to self-harm, harm to others, low self-esteem, obsessive tendencies, episodes of panic, and high baseline anxiety, 7 of 10. Patient described these symptoms as chronic and varying in severity, possibly related to traumatic events from childhood. Patient also mentioned social relationships suffering as a result of symptoms. Observation. Preliminary labs returned normal heart rate and blood pressure elevated. Patient avoided eye contact and appeared anxious. She only spoke when queried. Patient appeared detached, preoccupied with thoughts. Assessment. Following diagnoses are based on current available information and may change as additional information becomes available. Post-traumatic stress, obsessive compulsive, anxiety disorder, unspecified major depressive disorder, blah, 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 a bunch of stuff. Plan. Need to gather more information. Patient referred to psychiatrist for further evaluation and urged follow-up at clinic in 7 days. Patient encouraged to research exposure therapy. Ooh. Videotape. L. That's a little awkward. Maybe it's because I'm left-handed. I don't know. I put the tape in. Let's see what's on it. Yeah, I dig these graphics. Yeah, I really liked the Resident Evil play style. I kind of miss that. I mean, I know it's old-fashioned, but I like it. Oh, zooming in. Very cinematic. Watch out! Look out! Excuse me. See, I worked at Software Etc. when the original PlayStation came out. I remember we had like 70 pre... Do you remember? Clearly not. We had like 70 pre-orders, and this was back when you really didn't pre-order stuff. I think this was one of the first big uses of pre-orders. So yes, I had most of the launch games. Really dug the Resident Evil games. Ooh. Hi. Oh. Hello? L? Oh yeah. Definitely feels like a Resident Evil game. And sounds like a Resident Evil game. This wall is covered in deep scratches. Can you... Alright, I'll have to figure that out. Yeah, I dig it. You can hear the rain on the roof. You can... It's got the creepy atmospheric music. I like it. Some people don't like the tank controls, but I never had a problem with it. It's terrible out there, yeah. It's not so great in here either. I like the creepy camera angles. The TV won't turn off. There's a VHS player, there's no tape in it. At any of this stuff. Nothing particularly interesting. Handful of nonfiction novels. Nothing particularly interesting. I guess we're going upstairs. The stairs are completely blocked. I guess not. Can we go this way? Yeah. So is this back where we came from? Yeah. Huh. Sir, wait. What was the controls? Inventory. Do we have an inventory? No. Maybe missing. That's the one problem with this. These fixed backgrounds is it's easy to miss stuff. Requisite creepy painting in the weird old house. No surprises here. More books than I would know what to do with. One of them is missing. Ho ho! Need to find a book. Hallucinations is a trauma-based memory. Implications for psychological interventions. Routine information processing involves a process called contextual integration, whereby detailed encoding of incoming stimuli take place, which facilitates later memory recall. For example, being able to remember who was at your birthday by recalling a full contextual image of the event. Also, being able to remember what happened before and after a specific event due to the integration of relevant temporal information. However, during a traumatic event, the need for quick behavioral response requires rapid information processing. This is achieved through a temporary decrease in contextual integration and a quick response based on basic perceptual processing. The provision of a rapid response to danger is a consequence of a vulnerability to experiencing intrusive memories of the stressful event at a future date. Reduced contextual processing of the trauma stimuli makes them difficult to recall on a voluntary basis due to the lack of integration with cues which normally facilitate recall. However, the information is typically triggered by involuntarily by stimuli which have a perceptual match to some aspect of the traumatic event, e.g. a sound or visual stimuli that invokes a memory of the event. Therefore, within these theories, reduced levels of contextual integration are considered central to the development of trauma-related intrusive memories. Thereafter, the intrusions may be maintained through a number of cognitive and behavioral processes, such as avoidance in order to develop a presentation of PTSD. However, in order to be diagnosed with PTSD, the individual or the clinician is likely to be confident that the intrusions are in fact memories of a stressful event. A number of pages are destroyed. In summary, the relationship between hearing voices, seeing visions, and traumatic events continues to intrigue clinical researchers. However, a full theoretical understanding remains elusive. The subgroup of voices and visions which are directly linked to stressful events are likely to be responsive to interventions which are based on well-developed theoretical understanding of reactions to trauma. Oh look, a key. Key. Did we see anything that looked like it needed a key? Oh, there's a door. Is that a door? No. She even looks kind of like Claire. So that must be the front door. I guess we could. Might be something on the porch. Oh. Is there something on the porch here? There's the old TV. No, not really. Yeah, not really. So do we still have the key? Yeah, we still have it. Okay. What about these stairs? Nope. So those stairs are blocked. TV won't turn on. There's VHS. Yes. And we can't go up here because the stairs are blocked. I think we need to go out to the garage, would be my guess. Over here. Looks like some kind of hatch. The doors won't budge. Can we get... Where's the garage? Is it over? Where's the garage? Is this the garage? Garage door won't budge. Opening is too small to crawl under. Oh, can we open this door? I didn't notice the door. Unlocked it with the key. Yes, very Resident Evil style angles. Oh boy. Lots of tapes. Herman Hesse. He thought that all men trickled away, changing constantly until they finally dissolved, while the artist's created images remained unchangeably the same. He thought that the fear of death was perhaps the root of all art, perhaps also of all things of the mind. We fear death, we shudder at life's instability, we grieve to see the flowers wilt again and again, and the leaves fall, and in our hearts we know that we too are transitory, and will search for laws and formulate thoughts. It is in order to salvage something from the great dance of death, to make something that lasts longer than we do. Perhaps the woman after whom the master shaped his beautiful Madonna is already wilted or dead, and soon he too will be dead. Others will live in his house and eat at his table, but his work will still be standing hundreds of years from now and longer. It will go on shimmering in the quiet cloister church, unchangingly beautiful, forever smiling with the same sad, flowering mouth. Well, that doesn't sound problematic. So here's a bunch of tapes. Is there any that we can... There's a book up there. So any of these tapes? Boxes. Is there like a ladder or something? Is this a ladder? Boxes. Can we open the door from here? Can we open this? I feel like there's gotta be something else in here. We can't jump. We can't L. Oh, here we go, here we go, here we go. Here we go. Now what? Go up here. I feel like we need to get up here. So how did I do that? Get up. Get up. Huh? Now what? Is there... L. Use interact. L. Is there something to interact with? I feel like there's something there. Can we push? Oh, here we go. Aha! I flipped the switch. Well, that's quite an attic. Oops. Okay, here we go. So there's that book up here somewhere. This is a cool, I like it so far. I picked up the red book. Where am I? Hello? Guess that's it. Yeah, there's just boxes there. Can we do anything? Equip? Use interact. Doesn't really look like it. Interesting. Oh, red book. Right. This does feel very Silent Hills-ish. Um, Resident Evil, Silent Hill. Set book. The puzzles, and they go over here and get this, and grab that. Aha! Fake book. Ah, I wonder how that opened. Yeah, I dig it. I love it. It almost kind of feels like a little... almost feels like a little diorama or something. Like everything's 3D, it's got space, it's... it's like a little model almost. Like you feel the space. I don't know. I think it's cool. Here we go. To be horribly murdered, no doubt. Another creepy angle. Seems like they go hundreds, maybe thousands of VHS tapes. Each one is dated. It seems like they go back decades. Wow. Don't know. I mean, it is sometimes hard to know where the hell you're going. Especially with keyboard. More videotapes. What could possibly on all of these? What could possibly be on all of these? Oh! It's probably Pokemon episodes. What are we doing? Oh, do we have to move more stuff, maybe? That seems random that we moved that one specifically. Letter from T. Mr. T. Sam, I pity the fool. No. I tried calling, but your phone is disconnected, and I don't know what else to do. Everyone is worried. Your boss called Mom and said you just stopped showing up. I called Jane, but she said she's not talking to you anymore. I know I haven't always been there for you, but if you need anything, I want to help. What's going on with you? Is this about what happened? It was 10 years ago, Sam. It's not your fault. You can't hang on to this forever. I love you. Please call me, fool. Mr. T. Elevator. This is pretty elaborate for a free demo. Like if you bought a PlayStation game back in the day and got this, you would be very happy, I think. Don't fall off. Is there something to fall off of? Oh, more videotapes. Uh-oh. Look out. Look out. Look out. Turn around. Turn around. Heartworm, story program, art and music by Vincent Adinolfi. Do you remember the first time you realized
that one day you were going to die?
No.
Do you remember the way that fear went through you?
So yeah, that was interesting. I don't know if maybe we did things differently, if...
the way it paralyzed you? Do you remember that day?
Are we gonna see more?
Don't worry.
Let's see. To be continued. Okay, cool. I would consider picking this game up, personally. Interesting. I like that one. Let's see, do we want to do one more? Dead Heat, A Place Forbidden, Erasure, Fatum Batula. Huh, I don't know. Should we just do a random game? Let's do Snowy Castle? There was one game that looked like, Oh, fuck. There was one game that looked sort of, Let's see if I can find it. Not you. Yeah, it looks like it might be a little Dread Delusion. In the Clockwork God's realm, where pseudo-proved magic is regulated by machines, a dark corruption is taking hold. A small-scale open-world RPG. This looks kind of interesting. Looks a little bit like Kingsfield Ultra. Let's just do high. I don't want to blow up my computer. Creepy. Dread Delusion. This is a time demo. For early access, visit patreon.com/lovelyhellplace. Okay, no controls. New slot. Okay, is it WASD? Yep. Okay, and mouse look. Okay, so we probably came from there, maybe. You stand before an avatar of the Clockwork God. It makes abysmal sounds as it connects to the network of machines and spreads through the city. You shift uneasily while you wait. You have no idea why you're here. Being called before an avatar in person is rarely a good thing. The mechanical anatomy shudders and grinds for some time, sputtering oil and steam. Abruptly it stops. Just as you wonder if it's broken, a feather stylus pops up. Excuse me, and writes in large angular letters. You are subject number CXL. It's been too long of a week. I ain't figuring that out. Confirm or deny. Subject number that. Your data requires amending. State your vacation. Petty Enforcer. You root out corrupted citizens in the city, often by force. Scribe. You have a literacy permit to fabricate realm-wide propaganda. Requires mental wit. We will do Enforcer. Expand how you patrol the streets each day. Scouring information, banging on it, blah, 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 blah. You've been selected for the sacramental duty. Your heart lurches as you read the quickly drying ink. You do not know what sacramental duty is, only that those who are chosen never return. The sacramental duty is as follows. To find the source of the realm's pestilence, which purifies the soul and makes rotten the harvest, and to forever bring an end to this corruption. Failure will result in death by incineration. Well, chances of success are, calculating, none. Well, great. May the blessings of the Clockwork God be with you. Please exit via the portal. So I guess this is the portal. Oh, it's like a slot machine. Whoa! Oh, wow! Wow, this is kind of pretty. What the fuck is that? I don't think we want to know. We're just gonna just stick to the old path until we get a weapon. Do we have controls? Sword attack or cast spell? Equip sword, E. Move, shift is inventory is tab. Inventory. Equip sword. Yeah, I don't think we have anything yet. Fuck. Hi. Are you a friend? Oh wow, creepy. That's creepy. Real face. What do we have here? Another outcast from the city of shit and steel, no doubt. Tell me, has your god cast you away to die? Yep. Since your people are came and built that abomination. This land has been slowly rotting, so I'll keep an eye on you, outcast. Yeah, this is pretty cool. Wow, look at that. Weapon? Wow, it's a giant 20-sided dice. Well, I wonder if all that is... It probably is. So it's sort of like... Wow, look at that. It's sort of like Dark Souls-ish, I guess, or like Kingsfield. Hello. The town of Hollow. My people were never allowed past its walls. We natives have been here since the world forging, but even as we starved, this town kept us out. And in the end, when its people writhed in strange agonies, they locked it up and discarded the key in that tower up there. God damn it. This tower or that tower? This is more of a tower. Oh yeah, that looks like a key. Well, no, I guess not. So we up? Yeah, we're up in the tower now. Yeah, look at that. Kind of reminds me of Ultima 9 a little bit. Town quarantine. Key allowing entry into the town of Hollow. When the corruption reached the town, it was sealed shut and its people left to perish. Tower has sustained significant damage. Would you like to engage automatic repairs? Sure. Upgrades are disabled in the demo. Please have a nice day. Ooh. Saving is disabled in the demo. Please exit via the portal. Wong. So now we enter the town and hopefully get a weapon. Do 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 do. Door unlocked, key discarded. Do 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 do. Trash. Okay, so maybe, I don't know. Home spell returns the caster to Hollow, but at the cost of an affliction. How about a beat somebody over the head spell? Subject number CXLII. Your presence here was predicted. Do you seek help with the sacramental duty? Yep. Leave this town. Seek the cipher scribe in his tower. Pass the river. He will direct you further. Can you give me a club or something? Or a board? Aha. You pilfered one coin. Damn it, this door requires a key. Yeah, the performance is really good on this, and some of these, the performance has been a little iffy that I've tried, but this one seems very snappy. I guess my computer is showing its age. I feel like we get a weapon in here somewhere. Hi. Are you gonna murder me? You look friendly. Are we friend? 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 Friend. Try up here. requires a key. Whoops. Oh, key. Whoops. What was that? Writer's key. Fancy looking key which might open an apartment nearby. Better. You go there, it says no, click, you're dead. Yeah, this is definitely a very pretty game. Okay, so it's not that door. So, hello, friendly. Red means friendly, right? Over here. No, that's where we came in. There we go. Pilfered one coin. Creepy. You are illiterate. Requires a mind to read. Damn it. Potion of health. Set as a selected item with Alt and then press R to use. I would like a weapon, is what I would like. What is... Sword attack or cast spell? Use, look, tab, what was equip sword? Equip sword is E. So I'm pressing E and nothing is happening. Oh! Is this, oh, this is the home spell, I believe. Yeah, nothing when I left click. Wow. So I think we're supposed to go over there. Hello, friend demon. I have to come over here. Of course it does. Potion of stamina. Oh, yeah, you have a little stamina bar there. This lock could be broken. Give me a... I really need like a rock or something to beat people with. I'm sure I missed something terribly obvious. Potion of health. Hello, demon. Hello, guy. Wow, that looks cool. Maybe in this house over here. Yeah, very cool. Hopefully not locked. Hey! Coin. Oh man, I could at least have a scoop. I could defend myself. That requires a key. Where to? Oh yeah, we made it across to the tower. That's an interesting design. Very interesting. As you clasp the door handle, your head throbs, your vision blurs, and a bitter taste rises in the back of your throat. Telltale signs of an illusion taking hold. You're still atop a hill with the sacred city in the distance, but now the neon star burns golden in a blue sky above a glittering multitude of machine towers. Skyships ferry grains and goods overhead, propelled by faultless cipher magic. Recognize this as a Realm Commission propaganda, a utopic vision to draw colonists here from the old kingdoms. Machine Knight towers over you. The voice emanates from its sealed helmet, enshrouded in static. State your business. It leans closer. You're not from the Divine Order, are you? You mumble something about being from the Divine Order's lesser-known crossword-solving division. It's not very convincing. Well, comes a crackled reply. If you are from the Order, then this must be some sort of test. I'm not going to let you up here without the proper insignia, of course. You feel quite stupid. You have failed a challenge of might. You have suffered a mental affliction. Say you're from the task of the sacramental duty. You're not the first to have come here with that burden, nor the last, I suspect. I could help you, but I want something first. It points an armored finger at a tower in the distance. Of course it does. The tower at the bridge over the river is a Divine Order prison. My assistant scribe was there. She is surely dead, but the filtrate extractor she carried, I need it urgently. Your body tingles as the illusion fades. The blue drains from the sky. The tower crumbles to dust and the machine knight is gone. Is that where we just came from? Or is that this? Or is that this over here? Oh, maybe this. No, it's on the other side. Oh, yeah. Must be this tower. So it's kind of interesting. No monsters to fight so far. Very mellow. I feel like at some point you fight these guys, would be my guess. Hello? You are illiterate. Requires two mind. Filtrate extractor. This contraption looks quite complex. You haven't the slightest clue what it might do. The cipher scribe in his strange tower would probably be interested in this. The sword and strength this would break, yeah. Oh, here's a person. Hello. I must admit, for someone so hopeless, you're tenacious. But let me warn you, the strangeness that plagues this land, this corruption, it's not what you think. Attacking it with brute force is idiotic. If you really want help, there are ways. Come find me, we can speak. Otherwise, you're on your own, and then you're truly fucked. Yes, ma'am. Whoa, I don't want to do that. Oh, there we go, end of the demo. Dread Delusion, explore three distinct zones, each brimming with stories and secrets. Wield powerful spells and potions. Collect, trade, and upgrade. Witness a shifting story with player choice and multiple endings. Visit patreon.com/lovelyhellplace for early access. I dig it. I might check it out. Very interesting. So that's just a few of the little game demo things on here. I'm not going to play all of them. I'll leave some for you guys to check out. It's free. You don't have much to lose. So if you like weird horror PlayStation-era stuff, check it out. Talk to you later. Bye.